So we left Lanzarote in pretty strong conditions, but after a couple of days, things started to calm down. After months of preparations, we were at the start of what would end up being an 8-day passage. A couple of days out, we were joined by this pod of dolphins. This was one of the highlights of our passage to Mindelo. Days were mainly spent sailing, cooking, eating and sleeping. Everyone did their fair share around the place.
So what's in there? Just cheese or?
Just cheese.
Wow.
There's actually cheese in there now.
Yeah. There is cheese in
there. Right.
We had two fishing lines out all the way. We had no luck until we were very close to Cape Verde.
Oh,
nice. Excellent.
Hey, where's
that
stuff?
Okay, we've got it here. Keep it going.
Hey, can you see yours? Oh yeah, I see yours. I'll wait.
There's something on the stove. Okay.
What?
Chickpeas. Yeah,
turn off the chickpeas. Yeah, I'll turn it off.
Hey, this is a beauty. Are we ready?
Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah, we're ready.
Jim,
yep.
We need gas
okay.
And not
camera. Okay. Just one quick picture.
Good job, Kate.
Yeah. Woo!
Both Kate and Tom caught a mahi-mahi that day, which gave us fish to eat for weeks. The wind had died, and we all just got on with our daily routines. In the last few days of the first leg to Cape Verde Islands, the conditions were ideal for flying the spinnaker.
Music's kind of weird. It's like everyone's gone a bit weird today. Uh-oh. Tom's doing the cleaning. You're getting filmed left, right, and center here.
Yeah. Rinsing. We're in the rinse cycle right now.
At first it was Tom's cafe, now it's Tom's laundry.
This is all I brought with me.
Yeah.
So I gotta make sure I keep it clean.
Yeah.
I don't want to start smelling things up.
Yeah.
On the 1st of December, and after 8 days and 997 nautical miles, we finally arrived in Mindelo on the island of São Vicente, Cape Verdes. We were glad to have the week recovering, exploring, and preparing for the final leg to Antigua. I even got some kiteboarding in. This guy came over because he heard that Kate was looking for additional crew on the boat and thought he'd try his luck. Just before leaving Mindelo, Tom had the catch of the trip. The marina trolley blew off the dock in the wind, and Tom, after a few attempts, fished it out with a dinghy anchor. We left Mindelo on the 9th of December. Forecasted conditions were for strong wind, 25 to 30 knots, but from behind, therefore we looked forward to a comfortable downwind sail. The wind was good, the swell was big, but Polaris handled it easily, and we clocked 14 knots with just the Genoa out. For the first 4 days, we sailed under the Genoa alone. There was no need for any more canvas as we were averaging 8 knots. We enjoyed sunset after sunset. From day 5, conditions eased slightly and the seas calmed down. Cooking and generally moving about the boat became easier. On a long passage, food becomes very important. It breaks up the monotony of the day. As a team, we always ate together, usually followed by Texas Hold'em.
Oh, don't do the Irish thing with the potatoes.
We were nearing the end of our passage to Antigua. The conditions had calmed right down, and we were enjoying the slow pace of life. Just as we almost given up on fishing, Kieran snagged a beautiful mahi-mahi, changing our lunch and dinner plans for the final days.
Yeah, I got it, man.
Okay,
you're good.
Kieran, you're gonna kill me. Kieran's gonna kill me.
Why?
Because I didn't record it properly.
Okay. All right.
There are one job to do.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna have to catch the next one then.
Give us a quick shot in the mouth.
This is the fish that Kieran caught, and earlier on the trip, this is the one that I got. With only 2 days left, conditions were right again to fly the spinnaker. We hadn't flown it since the first leg to Mindelo. Forgive everybody and remember. For each of all, for every man a religion. Face everybody and remember. We were tracking to arrive at night initially, so we slowed down for the final day, so we would arrive in daylight. after 2,183 nautical miles, 13 days, 3 hours, at an average speed of 7 knots, we arrived at the historic Nelson's Dockyard, Antigua. After months of planning, we had finally arrived in the Caribbean. Now it was time to relax and enjoy ourselves. Fantastic expectations, amazing revelations, final execution and resurrection. Free expression as revolution, finding everything, realizing. You got the feeling. You got the feeling. You got the feeling. You got the feeling.